form the differential equation of the family of curves represented by the equation c times y plus c the whole square is equal to x cubed, where c is a parameter. Now, to see the parameter, c is a constant. Parameter means it's a value. If you keep changing this value, you get a family of curve, means curves looking like the same. Okay, suppose if you have, say, the equation y is equal to mx plus c, where c is a y-intercept and m is the gradient. So if you keep c the constant and if you keep changing the gradient, you will have different lines of the same family. Okay, so now to explain that, I've used a program called Graphmatic. Now this is a free downloadable program from internet. Now here, if I click on this, okay, so let me bring the cursor here. If I click on this, this pink looking curve, which has a beautiful shape, has the value of c is 1. If you can see that, 1, I put 1 times y plus 1 the whole square is equal to x cubed. So that's for the pink. For the red, I have changed that to 2. The c value is 2 here. Now for this white curve, it is negative 1. Your c is negative 1. And for this color, whatever that color is, negative 2 times y minus 2 the whole square is equal to c cubed. So as you keep changing the value of c, you'll get similar curves, similar looking curves. They all are called, they are all in the same family. Okay, that's what it means by family of curves. As you keep changing the value of c, you can get different curves looking alike, though they are different. Okay, so you want to find the differential equation satisfying or representing this family of curve. So now this is, let us write this equation, this family of curve equation, where c is a parameter. So c times y plus c the whole square is equal to x cubed. So I'm going to number this as 1 because I'm going to use this later. So differentiating both sides with respect to x, I can say d by dx of c times y plus c the whole squared is equal to d by dx of x cubed. So now the next step, I'm going to write d by, instead of d by dx, I'm going to write d by dy of c times y plus c the whole squared times, I have written dy, but I want to cancel that. So, and I also want to get this dx back. So I have to multiply by dy by dx. So here you can differentiate with respect to y of this function. So d by dx of x cubed is 3x squared. Now you can differentiate with respect to y, this inside function, which is 2c times y plus c the whole squared times dy by dx is equal to 3x squared. So I'll call this as result 2. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide 1 by 2. 1, so let me draw a line so that you can see my working. So I'm going to divide 1 by 2. That means I'm going to divide the left hand side of 1 by the left hand side of 2. Same way, the right hand side of 1 by the right hand side of 2. So this will become c times y plus c the whole squared over 2c. No, this I may make a mistake. I should not write here squared. It should be only y plus c. It's always good to check. So this is 2c times y plus c times dy by dx is equal to x cubed over 3x squared. So what will get cancelled? Your c and c gets cancelled. Y plus c, this y plus c will cancel with one of the y plus c. The x squared will cancel with x cubed and x will remain. So what is the next step? The next step would be So you have y plus c in the numerator, y plus c over 2 times dy by dx is equal to x, which implies y plus c is equal to, this is x over 3, sorry, x over 3, your 3 is already there, so this is 2x over 3 times dy by dx. So this, let me scroll this slightly up, so this implies c is 2x over 3 times dy by dx minus y. So I'm calling this a result 3, and I'm calling this as 4. So if you look at 1, I have got c, I've got c, so let me, I want the space. I've got c, in place of c I can put 4, and in place of y plus c I can put 3. So I'm going to write now like this, substituting 3 and 4 in 1. So you can see all the 3, you've got this 1, this is 3 and this is 4. So in place of c I can write, so let me write y plus c first. So y plus c is, let me put that y plus c first, so this is 2x over 3 times dy by dx the whole squared. This is your y plus c the whole squared times c, which is 2x over 3 times dy by dx minus y is equal to x cubed. You have to be super careful in algebra at times, your neatness counts. So here squaring both the terms, so this is 4x squared over 9 times dy by dx the whole squared times 2x over 3 times dy by dx minus y is equal to, I'm going to write x cubed as x squared times x. So this x squared will get cancelled. I can cancel this y x squared with this x squared. So what will remain? You have got 4 over 9 times dy by dx the whole squared times, I'm writing, doing more steps so that you can understand, times, you don't need to do all these steps. So I prefer to do more steps rather than less steps, because the more steps you do, there are less chances of making mistake. Okay, so what happens now? Let us expand this. So this is expanding. So this is 8x over 27 times, this is dy by dx the whole squared times dy by dx is dy by dx the whole cube minus 4y over 9 times dy by dx the whole squared. So dy by dx the whole squared is equal to x. I'm simply expanding this with the bracket, with the terms inside the bracket. So 4 over 9 times 2 over 3 is 8 over 27. Dy by dx the whole squared times dy by dx is dy by dx the whole cube, and this is nothing but 4y over 9 times dy by dx the whole squared is equal to x. So now I'm going to multiply, I want to get rid of this 27, so I'm going to multiply this by 27, I'm going to multiply this by 27, and I'm also going to multiply this by 27. So this 27 and 27 gets cancelled, 9 goes in 27 3 times. So your final answer is 8x times dy by dx the whole cube minus 12y times dy by dx the whole squared is equal to 27x. So this is a differential equation for the given family of equations.